गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ माई लेक्चर नंबर 3 फॉर चैप्टर नंबर 4, एल्बर्ट आइंस्टाइन एट स्कूल, रिटन बाय पैट्रिक प्रिंगल फॉर क्लास 11th, सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश, बुक स्नैपशॉट्स। चिल्ड्रन, आई हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन यू 2 लेक्चर्स ऑफ दिस चैप्टर एंड टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर नंबर 3 वी विल बी कम्प्लीटिंग द लेक्चर विद पेज नंबर 30 एंड 31 एंड कम्प्लीट एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ लेक्चर नंबर 1 एंड लेक्चर नंबर 2 ऑल्सो एंड देन आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग द टेक्सुअल एक्सरसाइज एज वेल इन दिस लेक्चर। सो लेट्स प्रोसीड विद द रिकैप्चुलेशन ऑफ लेक्चर नंबर 1 ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 4, एल्बर्ट आइंस्टाइन एट स्कूल। एल्बर्ट आइंस्टाइन फाइंड्स द स्कूल अ मिजरेबल प्लेस and the thought of going to school really haunts him every day because he does not like anything good in learning the dates in his history class asked by his history teacher Mr. Brown, and therefore he became argumentative with his teacher. Though his arguments were logical, but the teacher did not try to understand the logics behind the arguments and made fun of him and in fact punished him to stay there and told him that he was a shameful boy and he was really thankless and children like Albert did not deserve coming to school. Then he felt very miserable when he left the school that day, and then he expressed his miserable condition to his only friend in Munich, that was Yuri. Then he tells about the conversation took place between him and his friend Yuri. Yuri made him realize that at least he had a room to live in. That was corrected by Albert, that the room was there, but as his father was not very economically wealthy, therefore he could not afford a very good room for him, and he had been living in a dirty place. And he did not like that place because the landlady was a very voluble lady who used to fight and shout at her children every day, and her husband used to beat her every Saturday evening when he came back drunk. So all such things he described to Yuri, and Yuri corrected him, tried to soothe him by saying that the place where Yuri had been living was more violent than of his own. Therefore, Yuri told that their people are involved in duels and they are feeling proud of getting involved in different duels, and they are not even being corrected for their mistakes. Then he talks about the conversation between him and his cousin Elsa, whose father was running a business, family business in Berlin, and she used to visit Munich to meet Albert. And Elsa also tried to convince Albert that it would be better for him to study because his father's dream was to go back with diploma. So she said it is better to learn like a parrot and learn for the sake of passing the examination. You need not to study anymore. Then Albert corrected her. He said when he had no interest in learning the dates and all that curriculum which had been designed and being followed by the children, then how could he pass the examination? Elsa tried to convince her that it was far more important to learn rather than becoming argumentative in the class with the teachers. It would be good if he studies. Then she asks about the book he was carrying in his arm. Then he told that was zoology, and he expressed his interest in reading science books. Though science was not a part of his curriculum that he had been taught in the school, but he loved reading science books. Therefore, he carried that zoology book always in his arm. Now children, will recapitulate lecture number 2, in which Albert had an idea of finding a doctor to get a certificate of nervous breakdown, as he wanted to make himself free from going to school.
because the idea of going to school was haunting him. And he requested his friend Yuri to find a doctor. And Yuri found a doctor who was just passed out from his medical college. And Yuri asked Albert not to tell any lie to that doctor because Yuri said Albert was the world's worst liar. Because Yuri had already told everything to the doctor in advance about Albert, his nervousness towards going to school, his hatred towards going to school, and his plan of getting a certificate of nervous breakdown so that he would be freed from school for 6 months. Then, Albert's plan was to join some college in Italy. If he succeeds there, he would never come back to Munich. But if he does not succeed there and his father does not agree to it, he would have a second backup of his plan to come back to this college and join it again. Then, the doctor prescribed 6 months leave from school. Okay, this was the complete recapitulation of lecture number 2 I taught you, and Albert was successful in getting that fake certificate of nervous breakdown. I told you, nervous breakdown is mental illness resulting from stress, and he got success in getting the fake certificate from that doctor in order to make himself free from there, from the school. And his plan was to go and join some school or college in Italy so that he would be successful in his life, because he had started hating the school in Munich very badly. And he found himself really incapable of staying there anymore. And the doctor, who was the friend of Yuri, had really helped Albert in getting a fake certificate of his nervous breakdown. But before issuing that certificate, he asked Albert what would be his further plan. And Albert confidently told him that it was his try to take admission in Italy. He wanted to join some Italian institution for his further studies, because the curriculum taught in this school was not of his standard, and he was not interested in learning what was taught there, especially in his history class. The only class that he loved was mathematics in the school. Therefore, he wanted to make himself from there. And the doctor understood the mental condition of Albert about the school and his studies and the curriculum. Therefore, the doctor, being friend of Yuri, prescribed him 6 months nervous breakdown certificate. On the basis of that, he could be freed from his school at least for 6 months. And those 6 months were enough for Albert to go for a second chance or to join or try his luck there in Italy. Now we will proceed further with the explanation of lecture number 3 from page number 30.
Children, come on page number 30 in your book, in which Yuri's advice to Albert is given. I am reading from the very beginning on page number 30. "Isn't it wonderful?" he said after showing Yuri the certificate. This is the episode after he got the certificate issued by that doctor of nervous breakdown. He came to Yuri and he showed that certificate to Yuri and he said, "Isn't it wonderful?" "Yes, it's fine," Yuri agreed. "6 months is a good period. This way, you won't actually be leaving the school, so if the worst comes to the worst, you'll be able to come back and carry on for your diploma." "I'll never go back to that place," Albert assured him. "I'm going to take this certificate to the head teacher tomorrow, and that will be the end of it. Don't forget to get a reference in writing from your mathematics teacher first," Yuri reminded him. "Mr. Coach," willingly gave Albert the reference he wanted. "If I say I can't teach you anymore, the probably you will soon be able to teach me, will that be all right?" he asked. On seeing the certificate, in these lines the writer says, Yuri assures him that the 6 months is a good time period, because just in case things go wrong, Albert could come back to finish his diploma in that school. Albert reassures Yuri that this is not going to happen because he is never coming back to that place, to that school. He conveyed this idea of thinking the certificate to the of showing this certificate to the head of the school the next day, while Yuri reminded him to get the reference letter from the mathematics teacher, whose name was Mr. Coach. And Albert was very much sure that Mr. Coach will willingly give Albert the reference. Now we'll talk about Mr. Coach, who gave Albert the reference letter that Albert really needed for his further studies in Italy. So, if I say I can't teach you anymore and probably you will soon be able to teach me, will that be all right? He asked. These are the words spoken by his maths teacher named Mr. Coach. He said, if I say I can't teach you anymore and probably you'll soon be able to teach me, will that be all right? That's saying too much, sir, said Albert. It's only the truth, but all right, I'll put it more seriously. This was the promise of his teacher that he will take this matter seriously and he will give him serious reference. It was still a glowing reference. He felt very happy. And Mr. Coach made the point that Albert was ready immediately to enter a college or institute for the study of higher mathematics. In these lines, the writer says, Mr. Coach, the mathematics teacher, gave Albert a nice referral. He even went to the extent of saying that Albert would soon be ready to teach him, which Albert thought was saying too much, probably out of respect for his teacher. Mr. Coach then put it in different words, but furnished the reference in a way to make it smooth for Albert to enter any college to pursue education in higher mathematics. Now we will proceed further the text in which Mr. Coach appreciated Albert. He said, I'm sorry you are leaving us, although you are wasting your time in my class, he said. It's almost the only class where I am not wasting my time, said Albert. But how did you know I am leaving, sir? You would not have asked me for this reference otherwise. I thought you would wonder. There is nothing to wonder about, Einstein. I knew you were going to leave before you knew yourself. Albert was puzzled. What did the teacher mean? He soon found out before he had a chance to ask for an interview with the head teacher. He was summoned to the head's room. Summoned means called. Well, it saves me the trouble of having to wait an hour or two outside, he thought. He could not understand the comment passed by his maths teacher, Mr. Coach, because he did not know how his teacher knew that he was about to leave them. In these lines, the teacher expresses his displeasure about Albert leaving, but again, he knew Albert was wasting his time there. Albert instantly corrected him by saying that Mr. Coates' class was the only class where he was not wasting his time because he was interested in learning mathematics. Albert did not tell him anything about leaving, but Mr. Coach could identify it long before. Albert realized himself and also because of the referral. To his surprise, Albert was called into the head's room. Although he was not aware of the reason and he was himself going to make an appointment, but he was happy that it saved his time and the trouble of waiting for 1 or 2 hours to meet him. He took it very positive that he was called by the head in his room because he himself was planning to have an appointment of meeting the head of the school, as he wanted to show the certificate he was carrying in his pocket in order to get relief from the school for at least 6 months. But he felt happy that the head himself called for Albert and he thought it would save his time. He would not wait for an hour or two, but he would directly go to see him now. Now, the headmaster's information. He hardly bothered, Albert hardly bothered to wonder why he had been sent for, but vaguely means dimly, he supposed he was to be punished again for some bad work and laziness. Well, he had finished with punishments. I'm not going to punish you, the head teacher said, to Albert's surprise. Your work is terrible. Terrible means horrible. And I am not prepared to have you here any longer, Einstein. I want you to leave the school now. Leave school now? Repeated Albert, dazed. Surprisingly, Albert repeated the words, leave school now? That is what I said. You mean, said Albert, that I am to be expelled? Children, expelled means officially make someone leave a school or any other organization. I repeat, expelled means officially make someone leave a school or any other organization. In these lines, what is written? That Albert did not put much thought into why he was called into the office of the head. But somehow he knew it was to punish him for some poor performance or lack of interest. But now he thought he was done with all that of it because of the certificate he was carrying in his pocket. To his utmost surprise there, Einstein was told by his head that he was not going to be punished this time. The headmaster instead expressed that he is done with all his laziness and wishes to no longer have him there. Albert's first thought was if he was being expelled. Children, now we shall proceed with the reading of page number 31. You can take it that way if you wish, Einstein. The head teacher was not mincing words. Mincing words means to speak vaguely or indirectly. Right? So he said, you can take it that way if you wish that you are expelled from school. The head teacher was not mincing his words. The simplest thing will be for you to go of your own accord and then the question won't arise. But, said Albert, what crime have I committed? Then he said, your presence in the classroom makes it impossible for the teacher to teach and for the other pupils to learn. You refuse to learn. You are in constant rebellion. Rebellion means revolt. And no serious work can be done while you are there. Albert felt the medical certificate almost burning a hole in his pocket. This is an idiom used by the writer. That the certificate almost burning a hole in his pocket means that certificate became of no use. It was proved a useless thing lying and that was burning a hole in his pocket. I was going to leave anyway, he said. Then we are in agreement at least, Einstein, the head said. In these lines you see, the head of the school was pretty serious and suggested that he left school on his own instead of being expelled because it would be easier for both the parties, means for the headmaster as well as for the student named Albert. Albert still did not understand what crime he had committed. The head teacher explained how his presence is creating trouble for teachers to give lessons to other students and how no work can be done when he is around while standing there. Albert felt that the certificate was really burning a hole in his pocket, which means that the money he had spent on extracting this certificate, which was paid in terms of a meal with Yuri, had gone waste as the certificate was rendered useless. He was anyway being sent away from school. Regardless, Albert expresses that he was anyway going to leave, to which the teacher replies that at least for the first time they are agreeing on something. So the teacher told him that this is the first thing you agreed with me, otherwise always you were in constant rebellion, not only in class but here in my office also. So this is the first time you agreed with me and you got ready to leave. Now, for a moment, Albert was tempted to tell the man. The man means the headmaster. Albert was tempted. Tempted means he was willing to tell the headmaster what he thought of him and of his school. Then he stopped himself. Without another word, holding his head high, he stalked out. Stalked out means moved out. He left the place in a haughty, stiff or threatening manner. Shut the door after you, shouted the head. Albert ignored him. So, in these words you can see, at that moment Albert was being driven by his desire to tell the head teacher the truth and what he thought of the school, but somehow he managed to resist it because at last his wish was fulfilled. His wish was to leave the school that was being fulfilled. Therefore, he thought it was better to be quiet rather doing anything wrong at the last moment. He walked straight out of the school while ignoring the head teacher's instruction with his head high. Children, now we are proceeding towards the end of the lesson. Albert walked straight on out of the school where he had spent 5 miserable years. Without turning his head to give it a last look, he could not think of anyone he wanted to say goodbye to. Indeed, Yuri was almost the only person in Munich he felt like seeing before he left the town he had come to hate almost as much as the school. Elsa was back in Berlin and he had no other real friends there. Goodbye and good luck, said Yuri when he left. You are going to a wonderful country. I think, I hope, you will be happier there. So, Albert, when he left the office of the headmaster, he did not even look back at the place where he had spent the most terrible years of his life. Those were 5 long years. He had no real friends or any close acquaintances to whom he wanted to bid by. Then he met Yuri before leaving, who wished him well and hoped he would be happy in the country he was going to. Elsa was also back in Berlin with her family. Thus, there was no one else he could say goodbye to. This is the end of the chapter. Children, now we will proceed towards the textual exercise. If you see, on page number 31, there are 3 questions given where the text ends. The question number 1 is, what do you understand of Einstein's nature from his conversations with his history teacher, his maths teacher and the head teacher? So, you would have studied in the chapter in which it was clearly given how he conversed with his history teacher, how he conversed with his maths teacher Mr. Koch, and how did the conversation take place between him and his head teacher of the school. So, to answer this question, you can write, Albert was a boy who believed in standing up for his beliefs. It is evident from the way he portrayed his views in front of his history teacher. He is someone who puts his energy in understanding logic rather than facts. His conversation with his mathematics teacher tells how passionate he is about the subject. The teacher's remark that soon Albert will be ready to teach him shows that Albert is hardworking. He is on very good terms with his mathematics teacher, and that is why the teacher gave him a referral. This tells us that Albert had potential. He was just different from other students of his age. The head teacher and Einstein never agreed on one thing except when the teacher felt Albert is better off without school and vice versa. Even though Albert felt a bit insulted upon being shown the door, he resisted his desire to say anything bad or slam the door behind him. This shows that he respected his elders and was polite. He was not a rude boy. So all these are the conversations which tells us about Einstein's nature. Okay. Now, we'll proceed to question number 2. The school system often curbs individual talents. Discuss. Do you agree or you don't? That is your wish, but the answer to this question can be written. The school system focuses on teaching the same thing to every student and expects them to excel in all. While the truth is that all children are different and each one of them shines in his own way. School learning focuses more on learning facts than logics. Instead of teaching them how to think, they teach little minds what to think. Students are compared on the basis of marks, which promotes unhealthy competition and sense of inferiority among children at a very young age. Their talents somehow get overshadowed in the race of scoring ideal marks. The school system indeed curbs individual talents because all are taught the same things, the same curriculum, and the same expectations are of teachers from all of the ones who are being taught by them.
Children, now we are proceeding towards question number 3, which is your last question to discuss of chapter number 4. And if you see in your book, the question number 3 is, how do you distinguish between information gathering and insight formation? And children, the answer to this question would be, though it may vary from one person to another person, but I discuss the right answer you can copy in your Fair English notebook. So the answer would be, information gathering and insight information are two different concepts. Information gathering is concerned with compilation of facts and figures. It is just retaining already existing information which can easily be referred to through books. It only focuses on retention ability and does not add to the personality of an individual. It is generally concerned with history or something that has happened. For example, the history dates that Albert is unable to learn. This is what we are talking about, information gathering, that outside information that we gather from here and there, and that depends on one's capability, whether you can retain it for a longer time in your memory or not. And then we will proceed. Insight formation, on the other hand, is concerned with the cause and effect relationship of a phenomena. It persuades an individual to think. It teaches them logic. Gaining information that is insightful will help improve the overall personality of an individual as it helps in shaping minds. It helps one understand its surrounding and reason with them. Albert was more interested in insight information, that information gathering. He was a science and mathematics enthusiast, while on the other hand, he had trouble keeping up with history dates. Right. So this is the difference between these two facts that the writer is asking about. Now I'll assign you homework. Children, today in this lecture, your complete explanation of the chapter as well as the textual exercise has been discussed. So you people are supposed to learn and answer these questions in your Fair English notebook and send me your homework positively by 2 p.m. on my email ID. I repeat, complete your work and send me your homework by 2 p.m. on my email ID. By the time, thank you.